And now to the pudding side of things, if you like, the apple fritters.
This is a thicker than Yorkshire pudding batter. In the bowl, Judy, I've got 3 ounces of plain flour, same as you would use for Yorkshire pudding. I've separated the egg. I'm putting a yolk in the middle.
I'm going to stand over by the pan just actually
Fine.
While you're doing that.
Mm. 2 tablespoonfuls of water and 2 tablespoonfuls of milk. Just the same, Judy, as when you make Yorkshire pudding batter, you put half and half. Mm. This is just a bit thicker. I've got a pinch of salt in the flour too. Then beat it all together, and the egg white is separated in order to give more volume. And I've whisked the egg white just a few ready to fold in at the end. So, but it wants to be thick because it's got to coat the apple. There we are. So that is thick. I may have to adjust it slightly. And the egg white.
These really are very good to have, these thermometers, I suppose, aren't they, Mary? Because you do get it the right temperature, and that, presumably, the right temperature of the fat or the oil is the essence of the crispness, is it, of these things?
It is. If you fry at too low a temperature, Judy, you'll find that your foods will be greasy and they won't taste very nice. So the fat wants to be hot enough. 375 is the temperature.
Right, well, it's on the dot of that now.
Good. So. Apples, I've got 4 here, cut in slices, and then they must be dry. The batter won't cling. I mean, whatever you're doing in batter, it won't cling. The fish you must dry on paper or a tea towel. So there we are, ready. Thank you. And that's put that there.
Just
put in goes the ring of apple. It could be banana, whatever you want to use. Let's take this out. That's right.
While you're doing that, I shall go through the recipe again, Mary, and the ingredients
there we are.
For that.
Coated
yes,
it
I see.
In the batter thoroughly, and then a skewer through the hole in the middle. Hold
just to lift it out.
Catch it on the edge, and drop it in the fat.
Lovely sizzling noise, isn't it? Right, let's go through what we have got for those. 3 ounces of plain flour and a pinch of salt, and then 1 egg, which has been separated, and that gives a bit more bulk to the batter. 2 tablespoonfuls of milk. And the same for water, 2 tablespoons. 3 to 4 cooking apples, depending on the size. And then you want your deep oil or your fat for frying. And then, actually, when Mary takes these out and they're cooked, she's going to coat them just over the top with 2 ounces of caster sugar and a level teaspoon of cinnamon. I must say, those look very tasty too. And I know that we're all going to have a wonderful lunch now. Thank you very much indeed, Mary-Ann. Have an afternoon. Goodbye.